guys, it's Christina from Redefine Creative, and I am super excited to be here with a brand new series that I am starting with my friend Laura. And this series is called I Double. So the first and third Fridays of the month, we are going to share process videos for you. And here's how it's going to work. So on the first Friday of the month, I'm going to create a layout and issue a challenge to Laura. And she is going to create a layout and issue a challenge to me. And then when we come back on the third Friday of the month, we will be tackling the challenge that was issued by the other partner. So Laura will be taking on my challenge, I will be taking on hers, and we'll show you what you come up with. So hopefully that you will also play along and take the challenge and have some fun. So we are super excited about this new series and hope that you are as well. This past weekend was also the Secret Not Secret Kit Club party weekend, and we had a partner challenge, and so my partner was Liz, and she gave me three things. She told me that she loved spring, bright fun colors, and Amy Tangerine, and those were the three things I needed to create with. So I am using my DARE challenge to Laura as well as my partner challenge from Liz and creating. I pulled out a whole ton of Amy Tangerine goodies from loads of different collections. And that's kind of what I'm playing around with here. So I have this group picture from when I went to the Scrap Happy reunion in Colorado. And I was their like guest instructor for the weekend, which was super, super fun. And so I wanted to do something kind of fun with this particular picture. And I really liked that the purple in our shirts kind of matched with the bluish purple in Amy Tangerine's collections. And so I went through a bunch of different 6x6 paper pads and pulled out a bunch of paper that I thought was going to work. And then I fell in love with this heart paper. And so you can see that I am struggling just a little bit with where I want to put this, what I want to put this heart paper onto. So I know that I want the hearts behind my picture, but I couldn't decide if I wanted another pattern paper because I felt like that was too busy. And then I didn't really like it on white because I felt like that was just too, I don't know, bland or something. So I'm going to settle on this really great blue color. And it's kind of the same color that's in the hearts. And I feel like it's going to be a good contrast with kind of pulling out the bluish purple in our shirts in the picture. And so I'm going to create this long center element. And I put a little bit of pink kind of glittery cardstock behind it on the edge. And then I'm going to grab some of those 6x6 papers to create a little bit of a mat behind my photo. And so as I keep going here, I'm going to rip the bottom edges and add a bunch of layers and things. But Laura, who I know is watching to find out what her challenge is, Laura, for your challenge this time, and everybody else who's watching for your challenge, I want you to create a layout using one single designer and a whole bunch of different collections. So in this particular layout, I am using Amy Tangerine and a bunch of her different collections. So that is what I want to see from you, Laura. You can only have one designer and you need to include a bunch of different collections from that same designer. And so I am hoping, Laura, this provides a fun challenge for you and everybody else who is watching. I would love to see you take on this challenge as well. So there I'm pulling out just some larger ephemera pieces that I want to build an embellishment cluster onto. And I know that I want that to be in that lower left-hand corner because I have that XOXO paper that I want to use, and I want that to kind of be over to the right-hand side. So I'm just layering up, and I have these like 3D sticker die cut things, and I also want to use some of those. And so this one I really wanted to get in there that was this paintbrush with ink that says create. So I kind of adjusted and moved things around to make that work. And I didn't want all of my embellishing to be over on the left-hand side, so I moved that top cluster over to the right-hand side, and I like that balance much better. And you're going to see when I start playing around with my title elements that I kind of end up changing my mind about where, how some things are going to work. I do have these clips. These are like metal fold-over clips from Amy Tangerine. And I'm going to include one in each one of my clusters. And I end up getting really annoyed with them because the back part of the flap just didn't want to stay where I wanted it to go. Do you guys ever have that problem when you're putting embellishments on a page and it just doesn't like want to stay where you want it to be? So I end up taking my scissors and cutting off the little tab part in the back. So I'm left with just the little metal circles. And you really can't tell in the final layout, but I like it much better and I feel like they sit a lot better. So anytime you're using clips, if you're getting frustrated with the kind of clip part on the back, go ahead and cut that part off. You don't have to have it on there and it's still going to work really well to give you the look that you want. So then I'm playing around with these foam letters, also from Amy Tangerine. And I originally wanted them on the pattern paper, but decided that that was just too busy. So I really liked the one that says sweet and fun to be on the two edges of my photos, kind of off of my embellishment clusters. And then I wanted the third word to be down at the bottom, but it was going to end up on the heart paper. So I went ahead and tore the bottom edge of the heart paper off. And I'm thinking and knowing in my head that I'm going to add a piece of it back at the very bottom of the page. And so I went ahead, tore all that off, fixed all the adhesive that was there from me, you know, making a mess. And then I went ahead and added a little piece of it back at the bottom. So it looks like my title is kind of sitting in that little gap. And I really love that look when you have a center column and you can pull that part of, kind of part of it out and use it as a title or an embellishment area. And then I'm going to go ahead and add some of the January Sequins from Spiegel Mom Scraps. This is the Pink Promenade collection. And I'm adding little clusters of those right by my title. And then I'm also going to add them to my embellishment clusters. And so I'm going to have one up there on the top. And then I'm going to have a couple down here around this embellishment cluster. And then I have the two kind of little clusters around my title. I did go back, and I believe I did it off screen and added a little bit of journaling to that yellow heart. So you'll see that in the close-up pictures. But that's going to do it for this particular layout. So Laura and everyone else who is watching, your challenge for I Double Dare You is to create a layout using multiple collections from just one designer. I can't wait to see what you guys make, and I'll be back to see you soon. Bye!